I accidentally became a meme, and this is that story. My name is Kyle Craven, but you might know me as Bad Luck Brian. So this all started in 2007. I was in high school, and let's just say I wasn't a great student. I was more interested in goofing off and being a class clown. My friend Ian and I loved to do pranks. For like Cinco de Mayo, we'd volunteer to bring in the piñata, but we'd fill the piñata full of vegetables instead of candy. Dude, they were so pissed. My teacher was pissed, everyone was pissed. One thing I loved though was picture day. It was an opportunity for me to shine. Freshman year, you know, I had a grin on my face picture, nothing too special. But my sophomore year, I thought I'd up my game a little bit, and actually there are two photos, so it looks like twins Kyle Cravens in the class. So my junior year, I was really prepping myself, trying to get a really good picture. So I went down to the local thrift store, got a nice sweater vest. As I'm in line waiting to get my picture taken, me and my buddies are goofing off. We get up there, a lady asked, you know, what backdrop do I want? And I told her purple. She was a little surprised. As I sit down, I'm rubbing my eyes, making them really puffy. And she goes, okay, let's smile. And I gave her that, you know, that nice grin. And she took the picture, laughed a little bit, and said, thank you. It wasn't for a few weeks after that I got my actual picture back. When I first got the picture, I thought it was perfect. Me and my buddies all were crying, laughing in class, looking at it. Not more than 5 minutes after getting my picture did I get a call down to the principal's office, took me aside and said that tomorrow's her retakes, and she expected me to be there because she's not gonna put that photo in her yearbook. So with retakes, what you do is you have to turn back in the original photo. So prior to doing that, I scanned it, copied it, put it on my computer, and actually made it as my Facebook profile picture. Ian, my buddy who I mentioned earlier, who I like to do pranks with, in college, he went to the West Coast. I was still on the East Coast. And he would call me in the middle of the night and leave me voicemails, 4 a.m. when I was sleeping. They were very interesting and odd. They would range from, you know, I miss you, why'd you leave me, 9/11's an inside job, or like how they fit all those animals in that Noah's Ark, you know? How'd that even work? So around 2012, Ian was very obsessed with making memes. He would use memegenerator.com, post them to the subreddit Advice Animals. He would do 50 at a time. Usually none of them stuck. That was really until one night at 4 a.m. I got a voicemail. He simply said, hey, not a big deal, but I made you internet famous. So since he usually sends me voicemails that make no sense, I thought nothing of it. I was very, very wrong. Within 2 weeks, it was all over the internet, Reddit, Facebook, Instagram. So this happened the last semester of college. People were recognizing me in class as I was walking around campus. Always get asked to do pictures. I thought it was hilarious. Me and my buddies were calling each other, laughing. I didn't inform my family. I kind of let it go because I thought it would die like most memes die. You know, they pick up for a week or two and then they slowly dissipate. But this really kept on growing and organically growing and growing and growing. So my mom was at school, and she's a middle school teacher, and somebody was walking around, a kid was walking around with a Bad Luck Brian t-shirt. And she asked, who's that on your shirt? And he goes, that's Bad Luck Brian. Everybody knows Bad Luck Brian. She goes, well, you know, where'd you get that? He goes, well, I got it at the mall, Hot Topic. Eventually, I had to tell them, hey, there's a picture of me out on the internet. And immediately, my parents were cautious, let's say. It probably wasn't for the best that I had a picture of myself out there that's a meme. So one of the first things we did was talk to an IP lawyer to keep control of it, because we've seen from other memes how it can really get out of control. So I have t-shirts that were sold in Walmart, Hot Topic, Target, 20 plus board games I'm in, a little doll, a book, did a commercial for Volkswagen for the Super Bowl, commercial for McDonald's. I was on a skateboard. I am in a museum in Switzerland. Different fans, they always say the same thing, you know, it's always like, oh, I feel so bad for you. It's terrible that somebody took your photo and put it out there. And, you know, that's bad luck, you know, just fits the meme perfectly. But in real life, I actually have great luck. I win sweepstakes all the time. You know, I've won at Xbox, PSP. I always win at bingo, scratch off tickets. So being internet famous is great because 90% of the time, no one recognizes you in public and you can have a normal life. You know, once in a while, I'll be at Chipotle and somebody will give me, you know, that look and I'll just go, look, yep, and then a famous, keep on walking. But you also do get the perks of being famous, where you get to do all these crazy things. So met Snoop Dogg, Seth Rogen, been to Playboy Mansion, met countless other internet memes. Overly attached girlfriend reached out to me. We did a video together, one of her videos and a few other projects, and it was great and she's a blast. Looking back on it, I don't have any regrets. You know, I always looked at it as a blessing and a fun roller coaster ride we've been riding. I've had an extremely charmed life, and I am the luckiest guy I know.